Her and I always knew this day would come. We just didn't know when. But the moment we heard all that, we had to come out here to see it and feel it for ourselves. Are you crying, Mr. Regal? You are completely pathetic. You know, 1 week ago, I told you, you lost control of this roster, and you knew what I was saying was true. I saw it in your eyes. And then, at NXT TakeOver, when I punched a hole through the Mount Rushmore of NXT, you knew that I could control this place through chaos and violence. And now we're here. And I want you to say it. I want you to tell these people that you're leaving. And then I want you to walk your ass up that aisle and never come back. Say it. Say that Kross was right. Say it. Say Kross conquers all. We ain't got all night, Mr. Regal. Tick tock.
Mr. Regal, I believe you wanted to speak with me.
I did, Joe, but not in these circumstances. It was for talk later, but you're here. And I, because of my love for NXT, I think everybody deserves a general manager that can hold the position with the integrity and the respect that it deserves. And so I would like you to be the new general manager of NXT. Joe, I am no longer able to keep this up. I have put too much of my life
Regal,
into
Regal,
this.
Please, please, please. I can say without a shadow of a doubt, my answer is absolutely not. You see, I've always understood that I made your life hell while I was here, but I always afforded you respect. And with that being said, I would be more than happy to ensure that you receive the respect that you deserve from everybody.
But if that is something that I'm willing to do, Joe, there's some conditions. Number one, you cannot be a competitor. Number two, you cannot lay a hand on anyone. Unless provoked.
Mr. Regal, I accept your offer. Which only leaves one more question to be answered, and that's, what are you still doing in this ring?